Hi everyone! Welcome to our first episode of Mandawi Talks. So today, we want to support the Mental Health Awareness Month through this Mandawi Talks entitled Elevate Your Mindset. So we invited a speaker today. He is actually a brother from JCI Mandawi. He is our 2024 JCI Mandawi Executive Vice President for Internal Affairs. He is a businessman with a master's degree of business administration. He is a triathlete. He is a loving dad to his son, Jacob. So without further ado, let us all welcome Sam Uy. Thank you, Sam, for coming. How are you?
I'm good. It's my pleasure to be here, Beeps. Thank you for having me, guys.
Handa ka na ba? Are you ready?
Pwede na, Beeps.
Alright, so let's get to it.
Okay.
So, Sam, if you also notice, no, like today's generation, more and more people are experiencing this mental health issues, like overthinking, anxiety, depression, overwhelm, and burnout. Like even in our chapter or in our organization, JCI, most of the members are experiencing this one, especially those active members or those who have high functioning roles. However, we tend not to discuss it because we're so busy sa mga projects and activities that we are implementing. So with that being said, our goal here today is to talk about the ideas on how to improve our physical, mental, and emotional well-being, as well as how we can elevate our mindset by changing our perspective so that our JCI journeys will be a long-term and sustainable. And with you, Ibiki Sam, it seems like you're a busy guy because you're a businessman. You have a one of the highest positions here in JCI, and you're also a dad. So like, I'm quite curious how you manage your time. So how do you balance all your priorities?
So before anything else, I want to remind everyone what our priorities should be like. So we always talk about this in our OTIs to our new members. So our main priority should always be God. And then family, then work, then our health, before JCI. So as much as we say that JCI is life, let us all remember that some things are more important. Because if we put JCI before everything else, then our JCI careers will not be long-term or sustainable.
Perfect. Actually, I agree with that. We should prioritize God, because in everything you do, if we put God first, then everything will be smooth. And speaking of OTI, last week we had our OTI, and it was a very successful OTI. We had 8 participants, and I hope they will survive our roadmap. So going back to Ibibs, back in 2021 during pandemic era, you were the JCI Philippines National Director for Membership Services, right?
Yes.
And you organized a national program called the JCIT 21 Day Challenge. And it was a very successful program. So can you tell us more about this?
So when I was a national director back in 2021, NPJUIT asked me to make a program that will benefit all the JCI members in the Philippines. So I thought of this program to help them improve their physical, mental, and emotional well-being. And we were surprised, the whole team was surprised, that more than 1,000 people joined. And then almost 300 people were able to finish the challenge. So ako naman, I've been applying the principles that I learned for the past 3 years now, and it has made a big difference in my life. So today, I would like to summarize everything that I learned and share with you guys. So my other inspiration for this talk are Brother Bo Sanchez, the pastors of CCF, like Pastor Peter Tanchi, and the Mindset Mentor, Rob Dial.
Speaking of your proud, like, I think the chapter was very proud that time. Kasi ang daming participants, it was very successful. And sa mga speakers na mention mo, I also love listening to these speakers as well. I think the other well-known motivational speakers are Tony Robbins, Simon Sinek, you know them, Joey Dispenza, and lastly, si Vishan Lakyani of Mindvalley, right? So, EDB, can you tell us more or what is the first step to improving our mental health and overall well-being?
Our journey towards improving our overall well-being starts with our physical health and fitness. because our physical health directly affects our mental and emotional state. Basically, our mental and emotional state are connected because our thoughts affect our emotions.
Oh, I see. Tama. So what are the things we can do for our physical health?
Let's start with the basics. So we need around 30 minutes to an hour of physical activity per day. It could be any form of exercise, like sports, going to the gym, or just walking 10,000 steps a day. And then next, we have to always eat healthy. So it doesn't have to be an intense diet or anything. Just follow the recommended number of calories per day with the right balance of macronutrients. So that's your carbs, protein, fat. And don't forget to eat the right amount of fiber. So around 30 grams per day of fiber. And lastly, we have to hydrate. Drink at least 2 to 4 liters of water per day.
Ang dami. Ang dami. Anyway, when it comes to food, do you still eat in fast food?
Pag walang choice.
Okay, I see. How about sleep? What is your advice to us, like me, or to those guys who sleep very late? Because I usually sleep around 2 a.m.
Wow. Oh, so sleep is very important. There are some studies that say that sleeping from like 9 to 6 a.m. is still better than sleeping 8 hours at a later time. But I didn't do much research on this topic. But I noticed that I always feel better whenever I sleep and wake up early. And I get more things done throughout the day. And when you wake up early, don't forget to get some sunlight. So we all know that morning sunlight is still the best source of vitamin D. But it has to be early morning, before 8 a.m. So doing this can boost our immune system, improve our mood, and reduce depression.
Narinig ko na ba to, like the ice baths or cold showers? What are the benefits of this?
So this is also called cold water immersion or cryotherapy. So basically, you take a 10 to 15 minute dip in very cold water, around 10 to 15 degrees Celsius. This is a very common practice for competitive athletes because it helps them recover from your sore muscles and joints. And it also helps your central nervous system improve your sleep and decrease the effect of heat and humidity like today.
Actually, the ice baths are not recommended for everyone, especially if you have health conditions. So if you have health condition, make sure to visit your or consult your doctor first before trying this. And actually, whenever we talk about taking care of our health, it reminds me of self-love. So tell us, EVP Sam, what is self-love and what are the forms of self-love for you?
Self-care is definitely a form of self-love, but self-love is not just about taking care of your body, your skin, or getting a massage. It's actually a state of appreciation for yourself. So it means being forgiving to yourself, avoiding self-judgment, but instead speaking kindly to yourself. You can also demonstrate self-love by setting healthy boundaries or prioritizing your own needs or me time. And lastly, knowing your worth and not settling for anything less than you deserve.
Kaya parang init kasi we're talking about love. Taga lang, parang pinapawisan ako. When it comes to love, parang mahirap
ka na. Save that for another episode.
Anyway, I agree that it always starts with us, within yourself. Because if you show up at our best, we show up better for everyone else around us. And now that we discussed the things that we can do to improve our physical health and fitness, let us now move on to our mental and emotional wellness. So let's start with this meditation. There are many types of meditation like mindfulness, mantra, and visualization. What kind of meditation do you do, Timothy Sam?
I'm definitely not an expert on meditation. I just follow the 15-minute guided meditation of Headspace or Bobo Beautiful is Nice every morning when I wake up, or sometimes in the middle of the day, basically whenever I get stressed out. And meditation doesn't mean that we can't have thoughts. It just means that we are observing our thoughts without judgment, just like watching the clouds pass in the sky. And mindfulness naman is our ability to be fully present, aware of where we are and what we're doing, and not being overly reactive or overwhelmed to what's going on around us.
So like, how about listening to music? Do you consider that as meditation?
I think you can be mindful in doing anything, when you're eating, when you're walking, listening to music.
I see. Mm-hmm. like it's still up to you. How
you're
can.
Just reducing the distractions around you. Even when you're talking to someone, they'll put their phones down.
I see. Okay. Ellipse, one of your favorite topics is gratitude. Because, you know, being grateful is the best thing we can do in our life. So every time we are out of town on a Sunday, you like to share how grateful you are. So tell us, how do you cultivate the attitude of gratitude?
I learned this from the book The Magic. So in the morning, I usually start my day by thinking of 10 things that I'm grateful for. So it could be the general things like my family, my son, my house, my work. And sometimes it can be the things that happened recently in your life. But then at night, when I pray, I think of the best thing that happened that day. And I say, thank you, Lord. Thank you for all the good, the bad, and everything in between. Because I know that you always have a purpose for whatever is happening in my life. And on Sundays naman, I like to have some peace and quiet time, if you know this. So I can reflect and be grateful for the whole week and everything that happened.
Kaya nga, I remember whenever we travel together, especially nung sa Bohol time, naalala ko na while you were driving, you know, nasa passenger seat ako. Naalala ko nga, you were so happy and grateful sa lahat ng
bagay,
sa business, so, sa anak mo, and sa family mo in Manila. I noticed that some people are having a hard time balancing too many priorities at the same time. So what are the qualities that we need to do to become more successful at this?
In order to balance a lot of priorities at the same time, we need to learn time management. So we always have to show up on time and leave on time, or else your whole day will be affected. And we should have a very specific schedule for the day, and even better if you already know your schedule for the next 3 months. And this is very useful for people like me who travels a lot for work. So that means that I have to book all my flights 3 months in advance so I can block off my schedule and not accept any more commitments or responsibilities after that.
I can relate to this, because if you do time management, then you can prioritize things, right? So it creates a lot of stress whenever our schedule are overloaded. That's why we need to do time management.
And for me, the other important qualities are discipline and consistency. So discipline means doing the things you said you will do, and doing what needs to be done, even when you don't feel like doing it, with no excuses. Because I believe that your confidence level as a person depends on how well you can like count on yourself. And consistency naman, on the other hand, is equally as important, because it helps us become more successful. Because success is not some big event that happens in our lives. It's actually a bunch of tiny habits that we do every single day. And eventually, down the road, we get to a point where we are, you know, you get to a point where you are successful, whatever that may mean to you.
And success doesn't just being financially wealthy. It can be happiness, peace, or having a loving family. Tulad sa'yo. And every action we take should take us closer to our goal. So what about for those people who are feeling overwhelmed? Do you have any advice for them?
There are steps that we need to take whenever we are feeling overwhelmed. This is according to my favorite motivational speaker, Rob Dial. So first is deep breathing. So he suggests taking 6 deep breaths. So let's try it together, beeps. Inhale for 4 seconds. So inhale. Hold it for a second and then exhale through your mouth for 8 seconds. The longer you can exhale, the more you can slow down your heart. And second is to write down everything that's going on in your head. So this could be your to-do list, your thoughts, your feelings, your ideas, even your fears. Basically everything that is stressing you out. And then you look back at everything that you wrote, and then just choose one thing on that list. And do that one thing only.
Because it makes you parang organized and
more focused.
And focused as well. And I think we get stressed out because we are thinking of all our priorities at once, like what we do for work, for our family, and our health, plus JCI.
I believe that multitasking is a lie. It actually causes stress in the long term because our brains can only process so much information. So like I said, just choose one thing on the list, and then you can apply the Pomodoro technique.
Pomodoro.
To do this, just set a 25-minute timer, then just do one thing during that time. Then after that, you can take a 5-minute break, and then you can repeat this process up to 4 to 8 times a day. And also, choose 4 hours of focused work rather than 8 hours of distracted work, if you have a choice.
Sana nga may choice ang lahat. according to Tony Robbins, progress equals happiness. Do you agree with that?
Yes, definitely.
Right. Because this means that when we start checking things off our list, we start to see the light at the end of the tunnel and feel less overwhelmed. So how do we find more satisfaction in our work or whatever we are doing?
I think this concept is called Ikigai. Ikigai basically is a Japanese concept.
Ang dami ng ideas mo yung views.
So far, I'm learning. Things, yeah. It's about finding your purpose and exploring. You have to explore the intersection of what you love or your passion, what you're good at, what the world needs or your mission, and what you can get paid for or your vocation. So we need to find our Ikigai to be able to live a life filled with joy, with a sense of purpose that can keep us motivated every day. But practicing Ikigai needs continuous process of self-reflection because it's about living intentionally.
I like that. So you find your Ikigai, not your boyfriend or girlfriend. Yeah, I like that. So embracing opportunities for personal growth and contributing positively to the world in a way that aligns to your inner self. I remember the title of this talk was supposed to be about perspective. So what can you do or what can we do to change our perspective in life or in general?
Our perspective is the most important thing that we can focus on. So this can be the way we look at ourselves, our lives, even our challenges or people around us. So the goal here is to look at something differently from the way you've been looking at it your whole life. So like the saying, if you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. So parang we have to start seeing things half glass full instead of half glass empty.
So how can we have this mindset when bad things happen?
We can achieve this mindset by always looking for the positive, even in negative situations, because there's always a silver lining. So we really have to believe that whatever happens to us is something that we're supposed to grow from, learn from, and this thinking allows us to let go of so much control and wanting to force things. So for me, whenever there are coincidences that are too good to be true, I always think to myself that maybe this is the universe telling me that I'm on the right path and that I am exactly where I'm meant to be.
I agree. Parang I can relate that pag nasa work ako, because my work is very demanding, pressure, and along the way, ang daming rejection. So, pag nasa sales industry, you have to kinda always look on the positive side. Because if you will choose that negative side, it will drag you down. So, guys, punta tayo sa positive side. Ha? So, you mentioned that there are moments when you feel like you are exactly where you meant to be. Can you give an example of this?
Like back in 2021, it was my second time being EVP of our chapter. And I was being prepared to be the next president. But 4 months before the elections, I had to resign for personal reasons. At the time, it really didn't make sense, but I just trusted my gut feel and my intuition. And I also spent some time praying and discerning, and it felt like the right thing to do. And because of that decision, I was able to finish my MBA, as well as do my fitness goals like the triathlon, and I was able to complete 2 Spartan Race trifectas. And now, I am back in JCI as the EVP again, having another chance to finish what I started. So it's funny how everything works out, if only we trust that God's plan is better than ours. So maybe we can start seeing our failures, not as failures, but as redirection.
So just like that saying, in God's perfect time.
Yes. This actually reminds me of the quote by Steve Jobs. In the 2005 commencement address, he said, you cannot connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. So this made me realize that if I didn't do that thing, or you know, date that person, or live in China or in Bacolod, for example, I wouldn't be where I am today, or I wouldn't be in Cebu, I wouldn't be in JCI, and I won't have my son Jacob, and I can't imagine life without him. So knowing this made me grateful for everything that happened in my life, both the positive and the negative. And if once in a while we stop to appreciate how far we've come in the journey, instead of always looking at the goal or the destination, or gaano kalayo pa tayo dun, I feel like we will realize that a lot of things that we have right now are just the things that we used to dream of when we were, you know, kids or when we were growing up. So I think it's important to always celebrate small wins. Self-love din yan.
Always be grateful and know that lahat na nangyayari sa buhay mo is nakaset na by God. So it's okay to complain, but then again, let's always look on the brighter side. And Sam, like one of the things we have in common, kasi our usual topic on Sundays is our faith in God. And we found out that both of us go to the same church, CCF, on Sundays. And we both attend in North Drive here in Cebu on Sundays. But whenever we are out of town, we always make sure that we watch CCF online.
Yes, we always do. And I always enjoy listening to praise and worship songs with you.
Kahit
na naliligo ko sa CR, I can hear the praise and worship songs.
Amazing.
Very nice.
Parang naging habit na siya. Guys, let me clarify ha, just that JCI is not a religious organization. We don't promote any specific religion and we are inclusive to all. But one of our core values is that faith in God gives meaning and purpose to human life. So this means that we all believe in a higher power, that the will of God is always good. And if we follow His will, we will have more meaningful lives. So when did you start attending CCF, by the way?
I've been attending Sunday service in CCF for 2 years now. It all started when my friend Samantha made me listen to CCF service. And it really helped me get through this challenging time. And it felt like whatever I'm going through, I would always hear the words that I need to hear when I attend the service. And for me, it's a constant reminder to always do the right thing. It reminds me the right values, like love and kindness, peace, gratitude, and forgiveness. And it reminds me to obey God by avoiding things that are not pleasing to Him, like our vices or our addictions, or the things that only feed our ego, like money, pleasure, power, or fame. And we will know that it's only for the ego if it can only give us short-term happiness. And after some time, we will need new accomplishments, more approval, more material things to keep us satisfied. And it's a never-ending process. But if we have God in our hearts, in the center of our relationships, we will be more content and feel more at peace. And we learn to be more trusting and surrender everything to God's plan. So this is like my favorite passage from Romans 8:28. And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love Him and are called according to His purpose.
Perfect.
Sa manifest yun eh.
Sa ang dami wisdom today. And just, are you guys learning? May mga ano ba kayo na kukuhang learnings from Sam, Uy? Anyway, we always go back to basic talaga, which is God. And I hope people na those who are experiencing anxiety, depression, overthinking, or whatever mental health issues is that, please pray, and that will really help you guys.
And I think let's pray for them, right?
Yes,
while we're here.
I think we should end this session with a prayer.
I would like to read the ending prayer of Pastor Ricky. This was around 2 Sundays ago. I think it's a very beautiful prayer. Lord God in heaven, we thank you that you're a God that sets us free. We thank you that we have the privilege of worshiping you, that you teach us how to be in awe of you, not just on Sunday morning, but all the time. We pray, Lord, that for anyone here today that does not yet know you, we pray that he or she will humble himself or herself before you and say, I need you, Jesus. And if you are that person, come to Jesus and he will give you rest. Rest from all the travails of life. Not because the problems will go away, but because he will change you from the inside out. And so tell him, Jesus, I need you in my life. I am nothing without you. I'm tired of taking charge of my life. I want you to be my God. I want you to be my Lord and Savior. So Jesus, here I am. I know you will accept me the way I am, but I know that you will not leave me this way, because you promised that you will change me and make me a new person. A person who walks with assurance of salvation, the assurance of your presence, and the assurance of being in heaven with you forever. More than your blessing, Lord Jesus, I want you, because you are the greatest blessing. Thank you, Jesus. This moment, I receive you. This moment, I declare you have set me free. Because your word says, he whom the Son sets free shall be free indeed. In your name we pray, amen.
That was a beautiful prayer, Ellipse. Thank you. Thank you for that and for sharing this topic with us. I hope our listeners are learning and get inspired by Isam. And I'm sure we'll be able to help someone who is going through a lot of challenging right now.
Before we end, surprise.
Oh, surprise ka?
Whoever views this.
Sige. Ano ba yan?
It's just a surprise na lang.
Okay. Oh, that's deep.
Sabay ka.
Sige. Oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you upon the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still, though you are God. Find rest,
so once again, this is VP Ray
and EVP Sam
signing off with our first episode of Mandawi Talks. Thank you, everyone. Bye.